It's been a year since the BP Deepwater Horizon disaster sent millions of barrels of oil spilling into the Gulf Coast. Scientists say large amounts of the oil remains in the ocean, but the problem is there's no way to know how much or really how to get it out. If BP's oil spill has shown anything, it's more advanced technology is needed to clean up and control those oil spills. Wendy Schmidt is the president of the Schmidt Family Foundation and the title sponsor of the XPRIZE Foundation's Wendy Schmidt Oil Cleanup X Challenge. She's taken matters into her own hands. She's teaming up with the XPRIZE Foundation to sponsor an oil cleanup challenge, a chance for entrepreneurs to make $1.4 million if they can come up with a solution. Wendy, you put your own money into this, so I want to ask you, even if we found a solution today, and we might be close, can we clean up the damage that's been done to the Gulf so far?
That's a great question, Ali. Of course, we won't clean up the damage that's already occurred. It's ongoing. We're looking at a solution to clean up oil on the surface of the water. That's the limits of the challenge that we've created. A lot of the oil from the Deepwater Horizon spill never made it to the surface. As you know, it dispersed under the water. Bacteria ate some of it. Some of it dropped to the bottom, the heavier compounds to the bottom, where we have an oily graveyard that's buried the sedimentary creatures who live there, caught all the other sea life on the way down. And from what I understand, if you go stir that up now, it'll all come up again. So we have a problem if there's a hurricane in the Gulf based on this last episode.
Well, the XPRIZE has some A-list investors and advisors that reach far beyond the oil industry. Filmmaker James Cameron is one of them. Take a look at the brainstorming session that you all held last weekend.
We've got this vast column of water out there in the ocean that we get data points from different places at different times, but we don't have a daily kind of weather satellite snapshot of what's going on out there in a way that we can work with.
That's how the XPRIZE comes up with its ideas, and then teams from around the world, from universities, from businesses, submit their ideas, in your case, to try and figure out how to clean up that oil that comes out of a spill. What exactly are the judges looking for? How do you win that prize?
Well, we had a fantastic response to this prize, first of all. We had 350 pre-registered teams. So from my point of view as a philanthropist, this was an amazing tool to bring solutions to a problem with one phone call. We will have 10 finalists in this competition, and our panel of judges, there are 8 of them, are experts in ocean science. They're experts in, the Coast Guard, people who have to clean up the mess are on this panel. People from the oil industry are on this panel. So they see all sides of the problem that we're trying to address, and they will be judging our competitors based on the feasibility of their technology, the market effectiveness of their technology. Can we actually scale this? So it's a very practical, hands-on kind of competition that we'll be holding this summer.
Now, Wendy, questions remain as to whether oil companies or the government can either prevent or mitigate future oil disasters. We've just had a recent CNN opinion research poll. It says 57% of Americans are not confident in the federal government's ability to prevent another oil spill. 41% are confident, which shows me that there's some hope there. Drilling, picking back up again, the motivation to drill offshore, picking up again, given the price of oil. If another disaster like this one were to happen again, where is the solution going to come from? Do you think, by the time you judge these, the panel judges these 10 final entrants, we're going to have a solution?
I think the solution is probably unlikely to come from government or from industry. If $1.4 million can bring about people coming out of the woodwork to offer solutions, you have to say, in the billions of dollars of profits that have gone into the oil and gas industry, why don't we have a solution? Obviously, there's no economic incentive for either the government or industry to come up with a solution. So perhaps it will come from private venture money. That's certainly what seems to be happening here. And I don't think we can say if this happens again. I think it's a question of when. Mm-hmm. We're drilling deeper and deeper into more exploratory regions. The Deepwater Horizon spill was not a particularly deep spill.
Yep.
And the industry was surprised when it happened because the geology is fairly well understood. So we're really pushing the envelope. We're doing it underwater, and we're doing it on land.
And you and I share the view that a lot of it has to do with our insatiable thirst for oil. Wendy Schmidt, good to see you. Thank you for doing this, and thank you for being with us. Wendy Schmidt is a competition benefactor of the Wendy Schmidt X Prize Challenge to solve the problem of another oil spill.